that children with autism lack in communication development and hearing ability. But this is not always true. There has been many studies with regard to this subject. And recent studies reveals that in some cases, children having autism do far better in hearing specific things than children without autism. But going into a more detailed review, there are also conditions where some children with ASD achieve poorer performance on tests of auditory function than their typically developing peers, despite having a normal pure tone test results. So, specifically, studies have suggested that children with autism may experience difficulty with over or under sensitivity to sounds, difficulty processing oral directions, deficits on auditory tests of temporal processing, and poor speech recognition in presence of background noise. Hi everybody, I'm audiologist and speech language pathologist from Kapar. Welcome back to our informative podcast channel, Kapar Audiology. And today, I will be discussing regarding, do children with autism listen differently? So, to this question, we will be having few answers that will be in a detailed manner. In one word, the answer to this question, that is, do children with autism listen differently, is yes. But it does not mean that such children always perform worse in listening. Even this can be considered as one of the remarkable differences between normal hearing loss and an autistic children. So, yes, it is true those children with autism faces lots of difficulties interpreting the meaning of the word while making conversation with others or in a social gathering setup. Sometimes they can understand and interpret each of the pitch, rhythm, and also sounds of conversations, but with a notable amount of delay. So, due to such an inefficient response time, these children will find it hard to communicate in a gathering or at a place where more than one or two persons are there. So, it will be very difficult in scenarios where more people gather around, speak, chat, or they laugh and make lots of noises. There might be additional factors that influence a child's performance on listening, which also include the attention skill of the child, expressive and receptive language abilities of the child, cognitive abilities of the child, whether the child have anxiety and behavioral disorders, and also will depend on if the child is having any coexisting disabilities or diagnosis. However, for specific tasks and mainly in the case of auditory processing tests, such children may perform much better than a normally developing peer. I shall give you some real-life example that surely will help you understand what I have been explaining now. First one is regarding the buzzing of electricity in the wall. Being a normal individual, can you ever imagine the hearing of a noise which is due to the buzzing of the electricity? Yes, although you can't believe it, some children with autism reported such an incident. In actuality, this is the cause why children with autism show oversensitivity to very loud noises like rock music concerts or a social gathering setup. Due to auditory information processing disorder, they can hear a few of the sounds within a noise with more clarity than you. Second example would be a continuity error identification. Autistic children or children with autism are capable of performing better visual and auditory tasks. Oversensitivity to rhythms and pitch helps such children to identify minor to minor slippings of audios in a continuous video, while a children without autism may find it difficult. So, such children who is not having an autistic feature will have the video or see the video or hear the video in a more smooth manner. The third example would be the least distraction. As per the usual understanding, the auditory information processing capability of autistic children is a bit limited compared to normal children. But this sometimes proves advantageous. For example, In tasks that demand less information for concentration, maybe something like one conversation or a normal children get easily distracted by the surrounding conversations, views or any chatting that is going on around them. But lower functionality of the auditory stimuli, of the auditory limit, autistic limits, their auditory processing capability to the specific conversation. Identification of a specific sound from a noise is another example that proves this, the above. In some auditory processing tests, it has been found that there are children with autism who can easily identify some specific sounds from a chaotic mixture of several sounds. In such cases, about 80% of normal children completely misses that sound, which can be identified by the children with autism. Even in some cases, children with autism can have a or can differentiate better the roars of a lions and tigers. That is the different, they can differentiate between the roars of both these animals. The reason behind such overwhelming and unbelievably performance is nothing but the higher perceptual capacity of the children with autism. But yes, while such things become advantages in some cases, there are some disadvantageous things that proves in other cases. However, auditory processing strengthening therapy can lower the degree of disadvantages that happens here. If you have any further queries, this is regarding this subject, you can please write it to me. This is audiologist and speech language pathologist signing off from Kapal.